Intox on Nunu, Sleazy on Lee Sin, and Blood Dragon on Dr. Mundo. And of course, for Peculiar Game, Carianus on Shyvana, Corki, or Tabuno on Corki, Blonatix on Olaf, Coralol, Alolol on Janna, and Attack Man on Twisted Fate.
So we're going to get underway, and if you've just joined us, the blue team will be logiX, and the red team, it is red team on yours as well, isn't it? Yes, the red team will be Peculiar Gaming. So, honestly, Joe, which way do you think this is going to go? I mean, I'm going with logiX almost certainly. I'm guessing you probably are as well. I mean, it's undeniable the fact that their results in the throughout the league table, I think 9-0, they've just looked the strongest by far.
They have looked the strongest, and yeah, like you say, not really by such a small margin. And a lot of people will be maybe surprised to see Sleazy Weezy, of course, did play for SK a couple of times, was in their lineup even, played as their jungler. However, in this team, he seems to have had a bit more freedom, if you like, and he's playing that solo top role, going with Lee Sin, which he'll be very familiar with as well from the jungle anyway. But as we get into this one, are we going to be seeing any early invades? In the last two games that we saw in that first semi-final, there wasn't really too much going on, to be quite honest with you, when it came to the early fights, to the early invades. I guess semi-final of a big tournament like the ESL Pro Series, neither team wants to be giving anything away. Sleazy Weezy is actually just going to head his semi home, and I'm guessing that Intox and Severus down on this bottom side of the map are going to be getting themselves the golems to kick off the experience.
Yeah, unless you're a Russian team called Moscow 5, you don't tend to go for it too crazily. They would go in there, no problem. Carianus starting out on the Wraiths, and the bottom lane, of course, are going to take away those golems. Looking like the Wolves also going to Tabuna as well. So double steals all round, and Blood Dragon will be taking up that blue buff. You can see his taken away. Didn't get a great deal of leashing, I've got to be honest, from Kennen there. Kennen was very quick to go back to lane, making sure he doesn't miss any of that CS out. And a good chunk of leashing from Blunatix for Carianus there. So Carianus with that red buff. Blunatix returns to top lane. Bruce Leezy's Wheezy on the top lane.
That was a good one.
I always feel, you know, when you pick up that skin, you've got to be a damn good Lee Sin to pull out a little Bruce Lee skin. You know, you've got to be confident in your abilities. So we'll see how that works out against Blunatix in there. Akioso versus Attack Man in that middle. Kennen versus Twisted Fate. I think that one could work out either way, honestly. I mean, if Attack Man, I don't know what Attack Man's Twisted Fate's like. I've not really seen his Twisted Fate. I generally seen him a more farming hero, I guess it's safe to say, is the last few times I've seen Peculiar Gaming. But down the bottom lane, Severus and Intox on that Kennen Kog'Maw, Kennen Kog'Maw? Nunu Kog'Maw combo, which we saw actually pretty predominantly throughout the World Championships and through Kiev as well, actually. I believe it was Genja is certainly the one I think of. Genja and Gosu Pepper. That top lane actually is a bit of fighting going on. Sleazy Weezy and Blunatix having a little bit of an engagement there, really seeing who can poke each other down. Sleazy Weezy would be very strong on Lee Sin early on, but, you know, Olaf's not exactly too weak either in the early stages. But honestly, these are pretty even lanes again, just like we had in the first game. The lanes could have gone either way. I think this is similar as well.
Yeah, similar kind of situation. I agree with you with that one. Actually, down the bottom, we saw Corki going decently low. Does actually... Oh, yeah. Gank coming in there from Carianus. Double buffed up. Not quite getting in range, though. And Lee Sin will just scoot away from that one. But, yeah, down at the bottom, both Corki and Kog'Maw did take a decent amount of damage. Actually, they both do have summon a heal still available to use, though, which means that they're probably going to be trying to bait the other one in more than anything. Here's Shyvana in middle, trying to get in there onto Akioso. And that's a dangerous thing. With Attack Man having that stun up as well, could turn out interesting. Blood Dragon there with Mundo just coming through, getting the ward down. Actually, down at the bottom, I can see Severus's health bar just turning red there over on the left-hand side of the screen. He needs to be careful not to be caught out of position. But they do, as I said, have those summoner heals. Top again, we are going to see an exchange of damage. Not really too much going out there. We did see Mundo eventually come into middle as well, but nothing that he can really do at this level. Let's see, Tabuno's going to go aggressive now. Summoner heal is going to be used. Tabuno does get exhausted, but will Valkyrie away into safety. Still didn't use that summoner heal, which Kog'Maw was forced to use there, though. So maybe this bottom lane going to be where we see this first big part of the action.
Yeah, indeed. It's actually all lanes have been pretty aggressive. And it's just dawned on me that... hello. Where is Blood Dragon going? He's onto Karyana, said. He's going to get Coralol to come in support. But now they might try and close off Coralol. You can see Intro's going down towards him in Tox. Sorry, not Intro. I'm going to pull that one from Coralol. Will get a bit of damage down to him, but he's still got Karyana there in support if they need to. And Mundo... I think Severus was a little slow to react there. He got a lot of minions around him, so he couldn't really go too aggressive. Top lane, they're going to dive on him. It will be Sleazy Weezy finally taking down Olaf there. And as I was about to go to before the bottom lane came in, it's actually dawned on me that that Lee Ziskin, the back, it looks just like the Guild Wars 2 loading icon. It's like identical almost.
The dragon.
Yeah.
Down at bottom, again, Severus is going very, very low. Obviously, with the with having Nunu there as your support, you've not got that much sustain, okay? Janna's not got the heal either, but that shield stops a lot of damage coming your way. And we're going to see Tabunu trying to use that to his advantage here, doing as much damage as he can on the turret itself to Nunu before being forced away. Now that his minions are down, we are going to see the ulti coming in from Kennen. Can he finish off? Yes, he will. And there is a kill onto Attackman. And that will bring us to a 2-0. logiX, the real favorites coming into these playoffs. As you mentioned, they went 9-0 in the group stage. They battered everyone there, to put it quite nicely, I suppose. And so far, it's looking very, very good for them. Although I'd say this bottom lane is not an easy one for them. 47 CS to 43. Kog'Maw still holding his own with the farm.
Yeah, and they've hung around for a long time in this bottom without going back. You know, they've managed to just stick it off with just purely that Doran's Blade. Look, and Intox obviously can't sustain, can't heal up on Severus. So they've really done a fantastic job. But Taboon has also not been back either. He's just got them boots on. So 45 CS to 51. So Severus actually out farming Corki at the moment, which does surprise me. Because Corki generally would think should be stronger in the early phases. But guess that Blood Boil is helping out Severus very much so. And again, he manages to land a cheeky shot. Oh, that's going to be Twisted Fate coming in. Will they catch a stun card? They will do. Severus surely going to go down. That will be the first kill. Trying to get on towards Tabuna. Never going to be able to catch up. Instead, just goes for the gold onto that minion. And that means that Intox is also going to have to go back, because they're going to push on towards his tower. Actually, Tabuna will go back. That's a prime time for them to go by and spend that 1,700 gold. Hasn't quite... Actually, yes, he has. That could be a BF sword if he wanted to go directly for it. Be surprised if he does, though. Sleazy Weezy has returned to that top... with buying Ninja Tabby and armor, I think it was. I'm pretty sure he started with Doran's. I'm trying to think what he did begin with. Meanwhile, Blunatics, obviously, who has gone down once, is a little bit behind it in this lane already. We've got Blood Dragon stealing the red buff here, and he has done. He is going to head towards the top there. Sleazy Weezy trying to bite towards Blunatix. They're trying to bait him down a little bit. And they are going to maybe do a three-man dive on Blunatix here. Yes, they will do. Ulti kick away. Oh, Blunatix, you've just been caught completely out of position. That's going to be a straight slow from Blood Dragon there. They're just going to get all the damage down to him. Who will pick it up? It will be Akioso. And that has worked very well for logiX there.
Yeah, and that's a 2-0 Kennen straight away in the middle. Obviously, Twist of Fate did go down to Kennen, but that was a nice ulti used to come in for that kill down at the bomb. But that's the only kill that Peculiar have under their belt right now. And Lee Sin going to be forcing this top tower to take a little bit of damage in the process of things as well. Akioso just looking like he was going to have a bit of a peek out there. Again, down at the bomb, Tabuno. He's come back into lane. Double Doran's Blade plus a Berserker Greaves. But is that going to be enough to stick up against the damage of three Doran's Blades that we have with Severus, who's now got that ulti up? And that's where things really start to become a little bit harder for Corki. We can see instantly facing the danger there. Actually, he's forced a Valkyrie away. They use the exhaust to go in onto him. Severus now receiving some damage of his own. But some real back and forth damage being put out on this bottom lane between the two AD carries.
Yeah, so let's have a look. How is the things weighing out in the middle? Bearing in mind they've got kills, obviously two for Akioso and one for Attackman. Attackman with that blue buff at the moment had to go triple Doran's Rings. Akioso meanwhile gone towards a standard build and picked up that Hextech revolver. We've got a Tacman heading south here. Ulti coming out. He's going on towards the bottom lane. Intox already popping it for trying to force Severus to help him get away. And it worked brilliantly there. Very nicely done from Intox there. Used his ulti to distract Twisted Fate. So he had to stun him up to knock him out of that ulti. Now Carollo's going to come down. Oh, Intox might go down here. Got a little bit too far forward. And that will be the support going down. I think Blood Dragon coming in almost baited him in there. Meanwhile, in the middle there, you can see Kennen on towards Blunatix as well. Will get knocked away, though. And Blunatix just keeping him at bay. Will it be enough for a dragon here from Peculiar Gaming? I think he might. You can see Lee Sin is heading south, but will he be quick enough? Because this dragon's going down very, very quickly. You can see Mundo's going to try and get in and get the smite. Janna ulti will go out there. Good stun card from Attack Man straight onto Blood Dragon. And that will be a dragon. Very nicely picked up by Peculiar Gaming there. They are in a 5-on-2 situation. Blood Dragon's going to get caught out. He will be popped. Severus might well go down as well. Blunatix going to pick it up. Wow, that was just like a bonus spree for Blunatix there. Thanks a lot. I'll take 2 free kills and a dragon. That was a big mistake by logiX.
Yeah, big mistake. I'm not sure why Blood Dragon was even sticking around there, to be honest. He should have just gone away. He was low HP already. Not the kind of position that he wanted to be in. Akiosa, though, is pushing this middle turret just that little bit. Carianus is there, of course. And what is Kog'Maw going to come back into lane with? Vamp Scepter on top of the 3 Doran's Blades plus a Cloth Armor as well. Tabuno also going to head home. And he should have a decent amount of gold now with that dragon going down yet. 1,300 gold. And he is going to be coming back into lane with a Phage all done and dusted. His Attack Man just taking away the Wraiths as well. Extra bit of farm for him. And we are to a 4-on-3. So despite what looked like a real strong start, actually, from logiX, a game which, it definitely looked like it was one of those that could have gone away from them very, very quickly. They've brought it back in their favor. They're a couple of thousand gold in the lead, thanks to that dragon that they got in there as well. And they're generally showing us that this is definitely not a one-horse race, this matchup. And they are going to be definitely up for things. Like we said, they played well against Gamed in the... in the quarterfinal game, which we saw a couple of Saturdays ago, which got them through into this semi-final. So there's definitely no reason why on their game, on their day, they can't take down a team that's been so dominant like logiX.
Indeed. Honestly, it's given Peculiar a bit of an impetus to go for this one now. They're a lot more aggressive in the lanes. Will it be to their detriment, though? You can see Intox back with Severus down the bottom here, but Tabuna this time is not being forced away. Normally, he would have took a basic attack and then backed away. This time, he's sticking in there. He's getting that armor pen down, trying to force Severus back a little bit. Severus is dealing out a lot of damage still, though. So it's causing problems for them. Meanwhile, at the top there, Sleazy Weezy's now up against a fed Blunatix, effectively. You know, he got given those couple of free kills, which has probably not really done Sleazy Weezy too much problem. That's down the bottom. You can see Twisted Fate coming down. Nunu ulti goes off. Tabuna taken down very low, trying to get towards Corollol. Will take him down. Intox will take the hit for that one. Meanwhile, he'll drop down. And that will be Shyvana, actually, that picked it up. I think they probably wanted to give that to Corki. Tabuna is very low. Needs to be careful that Kog'Maw doesn't sneak in and take him down. But Severus is going to go back. And, well, again, this is what we mentioned right at the start. The thing with Twisted Fate, you can get in and help, and there could be ganks or top or bottom easily dispatched, and especially with the help of Karanas there. But, you know, actually from a 4-on, effectively, one situation, Intox did very well to pick up the kill there.
Yeah, I think so as well. I mean, he knew that he was going to go down whatever happened, so he's like, screw it, I'm going to try and push through whatever I possibly can. And, they managed to get that one in there. It went over onto Severus, of course, so at least he's got that kill. Wriggle's Lantern he's gone in for. Still on in the level 1 boots. Corki, of course, with the phage that he had before, has just come back with the Sapphire Crystal. Up at top, Blunatix and Sleazy. That's going to be hammering away on each other. Actually, he was double buffed after getting those 2 kills as Blunatix, and he's doing a real great job. And look at this. We are going to see Shyvana come in. That's a good ulti kick away from Sleazy, and they've not quite got enough to get in there and under his turret. But you see the Reckless Swing. When you feel like you're doing well, like you possibly could be safe from that, the Reckless Swing comes in and takes such a chunk of health off. Real, real dangerous stuff there. And Olaf doing a good job. 100 CS almost to 90. So he's slightly ahead there in this top lane. Both players, obviously, I say both players have died. That's a total lie. Meanwhile, down at the bottom, Tabuno is being pressured here. Are they going to be able to slow him in time? Yes, Intox did get the slowdown, the Ice Blast, but that's not going to matter. Now they're going to try in on this top lane to get in onto Blunatix. The Q will land, but he uses the ulti to make sure that they can't do any more to him. And he will walk away from that one. So an action-packed first game. It's still 6-4 in favor of Peculiar Gaming, the team which coming into this one most definitely is underdogs.
Yeah, indeed. So logiX, how are they going to have to dig deep on this one? They still have a strong team to meet, and Blood Dragon getting caught out again here. Well, and you can see Akiyoso going to come and try and help him out, support their attack man. Will catch him out. Very nicely done. Flash through, stunned him, and now have they got enough on Akiyoso? I think they might do. Burnout going, good stun guard again, and attack man picks up another kill. That is just working so, so well for them at the moment. Attack man now with the ulti down towards the bottom there, on towards Nunu. Doesn't matter, already picked it up. No, logiX tries to get away. Not going to happen. Intox, sorry, was the one I was after. Severus has, well, I'm not too sure if he wants to hang around this turret. Peculiar just picking up kills all over the map here. Very nicely played. And you know, Twisted Fate is doing a fantastic job. 4-1-5, needlessly large rod, sorcerer's boots. Thank you very much.
That was so good from Twisted Fate. Looked like he could get caught out. Actually flashed over the top of the wall, then got the stun card off. They killed Shyvana, then moves over and to get the kill. A great combo. Everything landed onto Kennen. And he's like, oh, look, my ulti's up. I'm going to go join the party down at bottom and get myself another kill. And that's a very dangerous Twisted Fate now. As we said, he was having to stack up the Doran's rings early on. He's now got needlessly large rod and the Sheen added into the equation as well. And that is going to be a very, very scary attack, man. And wouldn't surprise me to see a very Chinese ban, I'm going to say, in the next game with Twisted Fate being picked out of there. Honestly, go for all Asia. 98% of games, Twisted Fate's banned. It's all good stuff. But showing just why. If you're good with Twisted Fate, that gank ability that he's got is just so, so much better than possibly everyone, every other champion, to be quite honest with you. And right now, we're going to have PG moving in towards this Dragon area. Ward down from both team. But again, logiX, they're split off. Three at top, two at bottom. Not a good position to actually be moving in towards a Dragon fight, in my opinion. It's very rare that we see these split kind of attacks work out in League of Legends, especially down in those river areas. As we see them come through, Q actually did land there from Sleazy, but obviously not going to follow things up. Peculiar. Seeming like they're going to work down there. You see the card, the wild card, actually just landing on Severus and how much damage it does with that needlessly large rod up. And, oh, they've given that position away there. I think Blood Dragon may have walked straight into the pack if they'd have been a little bit more, covert about what they were doing. And now a real big dance around Dragon. All 10 players in the bottom side of this map. They clear out more and more wards as they go. Obviously, the Oracle on Blood Dragon, and we are going to see Peculiar start off this Dragon pull. What's coming next? Ah, and it actually misses there, the Howling Gale. That could have slowed things down. Actually, it will be picked up there in the end. The Dragon 4 PG. They are going to go in now for the fight. This Kennen ulti will surely make a big difference. Actually, it's only really across one of them, and I don't think that's going to offer enough up. And Blunatix goes down. Can they finish off here? Tabuno in onto Sleazy Weezy. He's going to not quite get away. And here comes Attack Man portaling down. Severus is now in all kinds of trouble. Stun card comes in, and he is dead. He's going to try and get Coralol, who just shields up. Last possible moment, he's like, I'm going to escape this Baron Pit. I'm going to escape by flashing. I don't have a flash. I'm just going to stay there and shield. And he actually survived it in the end as well. And that's 13-5. And again, from a great logiX starting position, it's just absolutely going against them. And Twisted Fate now up at 7-1-6. And Attack Man hardly having enough time to farm this game.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant ulti by Attack Man. He realized that they were all just sort of holding back around the back. So he said, you know what? I'm going to use my ulti. I'm going to come down to the Tri-Bush and I'm going to come around the lot of you and cut off your escape because you're all low enough that I can just whip you all out with a wild card and just game straight through and picked up a bunch of free kills. Very nicely played. Now probably going to go spend another chunk of gold that he's got in there and he will complete the Rabidon's death cap. Straight out. Very nice. That's going to be happy. So massive damage already from Twisted Fate now. He's going to cause... Well, he's going to be a big difference for them. 7-1-6 with that built up. And, of course, obviously the Sheen prop that you're going to get as well. I'm guessing he might be going to build up towards a Lich Bane next. Depends how it's going to go. He's going to pick up the blue card. Obviously, get that cooldown resistance down as much as he can so he can be using that ulti to zip around the map. And the target went on there, but it didn't really matter. Meanwhile, the top there, actually Sneezy Weezy getting pushed on by Blunatics there. He's got the help of the minions as well. Karenius is like, let's go, let's go. Oh, okay, let's not go. They're going to back away from that. And I don't think, is he going to try and hold out for the turret here? He has got Mundo coming up the map to try and help him out. Don't forget, the Twisted Fate could join them shortly. It's up in a couple of seconds' time. His ulti will be available. Here they go. They're onto the turret. Burnout, got to be careful there. Karianas taking a bit of tower damage. I think Twisted Fate ulti may well pop up in a second. Will he come up? No. No, he's not going to. They've had to back away. I don't know whether the call was going to come out there. He is double buffed up. And Akiyoso comes back down. And I wouldn't want to really mess with Twisted Fate right now because you've got no tower there. He has got Will of the Ancients and a Giant's Bolt, but honestly, he's that strong right now that he could cause him problems. 345 ability power on 20 minutes. That's big.
Yeah, that's real big. Such a danger he's going to be now as well, if he wasn't already more of one, zipping all over the place. Corki as well is 306. That's a big lead, in fact, over the kills that he's got over Severus. He's actually going to go 1v1. He's like, you can use your summon heal, and here comes a Twisted Fate in the back. Oh, he's been stunned up there, but is it going to be enough? He got the stun card off. It did get him the kill there onto Kog'Maw. They're going to chase down now after Kog'Maw was trying to get in and take him down, and Attackman's escaping this one. Corollol, I'm not too sure if he's so lucky, though, and we can see the damage coming in there for Attackman, and he's... It almost looks like he wants to stick around, wants to see this through. Tabuna now in trouble, and he goes down to Akaiso. Intox fell fairly low, but for that kill, they've taken down this top turret of Peculiar, and I don't think they'll be too unhappy about that. Okay, it probably would have been best if they just left Corollol to go down in the end and, you know, survive with Corki and Twisted Fate, but such is life, and such is a bottom lane, such harmony between them. They can't stand to see each other die.
Yeah, indeed. They tried to stick it out, and Twisted Fate was like, well, I kind of want to stick around, but I would go down if I did. Didn't want to give them that gold chunk that they would have got from it. 8-1-6, though, Twisted Fate. And like you said, he did get the Kog'Maw kill, so he is very, very fed right now. Picked up another Blasting Wand as well on the way back. So Attackman currently with that Brilliance Pot running as well, 422 ability power. Really very strong. Massive difference in this game. Hasn't got his ulti up just yet, so Kennen is safe in the middle at the moment. I could see they are gathering around him, though, so he needs to be a little careful. The target's gone down on his head as well. Remember, there is no mid-turret. They've seen Lee Sin coming in. They have a four-man push around here, and again, Olaf back to farming up that top lane. Olaf's going to cause a problem as well. He's got that Warmogs built up now. He's going to start building towards something chunky, and that health will start ticking up, obviously, that you get from the Warmogs. Let's see whether it's stacked up yet. You can see, yep, 210 stack health on it already. Very nicely done. And the dragon will be due, say, not for a while, is it? And it wasn't that many minutes ago until they picked it up. My maths isn't that far out, but I'm pretty sure it's a while to go, and that's why they've just warded it up instead. So they are going to continue pushing this bottom tower. Bottom tower really not with a lot of health on it. 480 hit points would go down very quickly. And Twisted Fate, well, he's back in the middle, but remember, he can zip around anywhere. Olaf is sort of lingering around, and they are getting in position. They haven't got any ward placements to spot. Well, they will see Kennen right now. They're going to see him pass straight over. Will Olaf catch on to him? Yes, he will do. Twisted Fate's coming in there. Hasn't got the yellow card pulled, though, so he's not going to get the stun. He will get the slowdown if he holds it out. He's going to throw a wild card out eventually. Yes, he will do. Akiyoso trying to use everything to get away from this one. Will maybe get away. No, it won't, because the tick from Blunatics will finish him off. And honestly, that was a very free kill. Though it really didn't put up a great deal of resistance there, Joe.
Yeah, not good whatsoever. I think it was more of a case of, right, I just have to escape from this one. And that's, you know, this aggressive ward. All right, it was a little bit of a look at the timing as well as they came in. But look at this. Peculiar on 23 minutes going to head their way up towards Dragon. There are two around, Blood Dragon and Sleazy, which are two of the obviously healthier members of this logiX side. And I don't think that Peculiar are going to take this one down very quickly. But is it more of a case of forcing a big fight now? See the Howling Gale go out, and they are going to finally peel off onto it. And they realize, well, they've backed away as well. And, you know, the longer this Baron fight goes on, then it's actually bad for Peculiar. Janna ulti will be used. Blood Dragon going to get stunned. Is he going to be finished off? Surely, yes, he will. Here's the ulti, though, from Nunu. It's done a good chunk of damage. I'm not sure it's enough. Intox being focused. Severux is just absolutely exploded. And well, Sleazy will just move away onto Akioso. Tabuna will back away from that one. And that is going to be a 3-for-1. Obviously, Baron didn't go down in that exchange, but I feel that the Janna ulti there, Demon, was so, so important. They'd gone very low just from the damage from Dragon, from Baron. And without that Janna ulti, I think that could have been a little bit different.
Yeah, and they hit it at the right time, though. But as soon as Attackman went, said, here, have a wild card across all of you. They just all dropped dead. It was that much of a quick turn. He has got that Lich Bane complete now. The Dragon will be picked up actually by Sleazy and Akioso, so they're going to try and take something from this one. 18-7, though, very much a one-sided game right now, and it is all about this Attack Man. Will he spot them in time on that Dragon? They are just going to finish it off, and they will pick it up. But Attack Man's going to take blue, keep that cooldown running, and they have a huge advantage. Now remember, coming into this game, logiX were the favorites. They are the favorites. They are big, big favorites. So this is quite a turnaround for Peculiar Gaming here. They are doing a fantastic job. Like you mentioned, almost certainly going to see a Twisty Fate ban in the next game because he's ripping them apart. 10-1-8. But the rest of the team, the problem you have when it gets like this, if the other team can pick you off and focus you, suddenly you realize, actually, we don't have that much damage across the rest of the team. That said, though, I can see Corki is pretty well built up. He's got that Trinity Force on there, which, as Freecores points out, does massive damage. And he has that BF Sword on him as well, so he really will be doing big chunks of damage as well. Olaf as well has been pretty much free farming the entire game. We're against Sleazy Weezy. Sleazy Weezy's now forced to engage, and meanwhile the four-man push from Peculiar on towards that middle turret. They're going to try and cut off here and go towards Olaf. They realize Olaf and Sleazy Weezy are going for it. They have a stack there, and Attack Man immediately comes around. And they have that huge stack. I think that's going to be the inner turret down. So first inner turret of the game will go to Peculiar Gaming. And that is 3-0 in turrets overall. Blue buff is not up, so they're going to have to pass that one by. And they're actually all stood on top of that ward, which I'll spot because Coralol has got the Oracle on. Ooh, tried to bait there. They tried to be bait there. You can see as the ward was there, they all pressed B, took the ward down just to think they were still going back and tried to bait all Mundo into them. Didn't go for it, though. And the Wolves are going to get stolen away by Bluntix. Bluntix has been spotted, though. Severus needs to be careful he doesn't get picked off on that side. So we have a stack of minions in the middle. They're quite happily beating away. Sorry, down the bottom. Top lane is actually pushed by minions. And now you can see Peculiar going to go around and try and steal away this red. Just that one wild card wiping out them stack. And I think they will get the red. We won't see too much of a steal here. I'd be amazed if logiX can get in and steal this one away. You can see the Kog'Maw's going to try it with his ulti, but way too late. And got smited down as well, I believe. So, no, he didn't actually. But Karania still got it. That's just pure damage. That's how much damage they have. They're just, you know what, Joe? They're just absolutely. Oh, where's the ulti going? Well, he used it. Didn't go anywhere, Attack Man there. I think he just used it to see where they were.
Yeah.
Yeah, just purely used it to see where they were. Didn't bother going anywhere. Take the turret down and back away.
Yeah, I mean, that's something that Twist of Fate use ulti is super useful as well. Get the vision over everyone. Okay, maybe they're not in a position where you're going to be using the teleport side of it, but still, it's always a great feature to have, especially when you're a 10-1-8 Twisted Fate, which nicely rhymes just for the end of that one as well. So, the team of Peculiar all going back, and one can only assume that that means they are gearing up to get themselves ready for Baron. Corki does have the elixir on him. Twisted Fate probably doesn't need it at this point. He's finished Lich Bane. Got the Hexsec Revolver in there. Obviously, Rabadon's Death Cap was finished early on by him as well. And they just want to push these minions down this mid lane a little bit. And clear out the wards there. Coralol doing a good job. Obviously, Oracle up. And he's going to find himself a second tier. There we go. Ward's all out of it. If you press F1 here, we can see that there's no vision. Aside from that one that they've just put down in the corner bush for logiX. Question is, though, what kind of chance do they really have to take a clean Baron right now? It's kind of obvious from logiX's point of view that Peculiar will be there ready and waiting. The question is, do they set up a trap here in this brush? Actually, the Kog'Maw ulti did miss there, and they've managed to get Blood Dragon into it, and they are going to take Blood Dragon. Akaiso actually will flash in there. He's now been ignited, and they're going to push down. Nunu's ulti goes off. They don't actually care about it by the looks of things. They've just ignored it completely. Akaiso now going low, and he has Twisted Fate. Say thank you very much for the kill. Oh, and Sleazy's right there in front of him as well. Not sure that he's going to be able to pull out the yellow card in time. No, not quite. But that is a very nice, clean and easy 3-0 in favour of Peculiar. And I tell you what, that was a little bit unlucky from logiX. They didn't have the Vision Demon. And what they did was a cleaver in from Mundo on the right side. And the Kog'Maw ulti went in. Neither of them actually came up with anything. So I think they assumed, all right, they're on Baron now. But obviously they weren't.
Exactly, yeah.
And then we saw Kennen actually work his way straight in there. I think he was knocked away by the Janna ulti. Yet Janna ulti knocked him straight back into the middle of the lane. And from that point on, they were just losing men. And Baron goes over to Peculiar, hard-earned Baron as well. 21 kills for 7 after being, what was it, 3-0 behind, looking like a perfect start for logiX. Great play by Peculiar in this match.
Yeah, absolutely. You just look at the gold. Just look at the gold. Twisted Fate's got more gold than Mundo and Nunu added together. He's just absolutely hoarding it right now. He's sitting on 1,600 gold as well, so I have no idea what he's going to go buy. Probably maybe go Will of the Ancients, maybe go whatever the hell he likes, really, honestly. He's got that much gold in there. 11-1-10 for Twisted Fate, doing a fantastic job. And like you mentioned, it was the cleaver and the shuriken went across, so they just thought, it's clear, let's face check the bush. But unfortunately, Peculiar had read that, thought we'd dodge these. They're going to face check the push. And they got straight in position on him. And Blood Dragon, honestly, he went down in seconds. For a Mundo, that's a scary thing because he relies on that health. That's everything.
That
his damage
is Mundo.
His tankiness. Mundo is all about the health. For a Mundo to drop that quick, you realize just how much damage they have. And the thing is to boot now with that Tabuna, with that Infinity Edge and Trinity Force, he's going to be doing crazy damage as well. And honestly, I'm really not too sure what they're going to be able to do about this one. 21-7, Dragon is up. You can see Olaf going to go down and get that one. And remember, don't forget, Blunetix was gifted those kills early on. That's sort of what started it all on that Dragon. He was just gifted those 2 free kills. Had that Warmogs built really early on. Now got the Starks, or Zeeks, whatever you'd like to call it these days, and Atmar's Impaler on there. So he's going to be doing crazy damage as well. So really, all around from Peculiar Gaming, there is massive chunks of damage going to be done. Corollon needs to be careful he didn't get caught out there. Tries to pick up that ward placement in the bush. Meanwhile, you can see that Tabuna is pushing this bottom turret. The rest of the team trying to react, but they're going to be too slow. That turret will go down. And, well, I'm not too sure whether logiX want to... Yeah, they're going to say they need to back away from that one. They can't fight for it. And honestly, Peculiar are doing a great job of pushing home the advantage they built themselves. They worked hard for that advantage early on. And apart from the 2 free kills logiX gave them, of course. But, yeah, they're doing a fantastic job of driving home the advantages, which often you do see teams sort of messing up on, especially when they're the underdogs. Whether they class themselves as the underdogs, it's another matter.
Yeah, I was going to say, we said before this one, possibly Peculiar are the underdog of these final 4 teams. However, well, showing it against the definite favourite, there's no question about that one, after that 9-0 group stage, that, you know, they are definitely no pushovers in this one, and logiX going to find themselves in a difficult position if they somehow manage to come out and win this one, which is not looking likely whatsoever. And they're going to have to start off, as I said, most probably with a Twisted Fate ban in game number 2. And we'll see exactly how this one goes. Peculiar now going to be storming down this top lane. And logiX got the job just to literally defend as hard as they can against a team with full HP almost. Plus, of course, the Baron buff running on them. Actually, Tabuno's taking a couple of hits there. Cleaver coming over the side of the wall. But you can see those wild cards, when they go in there, when they connect, and you know, they're the slowest moving things, almost as slow as a Soraka banana, which is annoying. But you know, if you get hit by one of them, and how much AP has he got now? 653 AP with that Baron buff running, which is a lot of AP, if you didn't already realize that. It's definitely dangerous, dangerous times here. But logiX are doing the right thing. They're not pushing out anywhere. They're just sticking to these base turrets that they've got remaining still and trying to repel any kind of attack. But I think that PG may just go and try and split push this one now. That'd be a good thing from their point of view.
Yeah, and then actually Attackman building up a Zonya's, I think, here as well. It looks like a Zonya's Hourglass, which is just going to make him so much stronger. They are just split pushing them lanes. And I think it's Tabuna seems to be the one making the calls, actually, because every time he's the one that sort of goes off to the lane, the rest of the team follow. Meanwhile, down the bottom, they're just forcing their way in towards there. Actually baited them away a little bit with Corki in that middle. And Balintik's trying to sneak a couple of hits in on that tower. Only took up, shredded a couple of hundred hit points off, though. But you can see Twisted Fate again up the top here. So they're just completely split pushing the entire team. Olaf's still lingering down the bottom. Attack Man in the top on Twisted Fate. And Corki and Janna push in the middle. And obviously stretching logiX to their breaking point here. Can they take them out, though? Severus is now a long way away. He's at the top. Bottom would be the ideal place to go. Remember, Twisted Fate, if he needs to, can just port straight down here. They're going to try it to anything, really, just try and bait them away. Big chunk of damage going down on Blood Dragon there. Forces him off. He's going to go back to Fountain. No, he's going to try and hang around. Honestly, I think it's just a case of trying to bait the way in there. They just want to force any advantage, split them up, and get any way in there. Just they can't get a free turret. They don't feel they're quite strong enough, I don't think, to dive on the turret, which is probably wise, actually, because they don't want to give away something so quickly that the Baron is about to spawn as well. So which is why I think we're probably going to see them all back off. You can see Karianas just farming up. Yeah, Attackman's backing off as well. They've all got another massive amount of gold. They've all got 2k on them. So they're just going to go spend up. Zonya's Hourglass completed now. And I don't think Twisted Fate can really get a great deal stronger. 626 AP and counting.
Yeah, I mean, he's got the Hextech Revolver in there, which you can switch off to Will of Ancients later. Obviously, he's still got a Doran's Blade in there, which,
He might as well just go get the Meki Soul Stealer and just be done with it. go full Korean.
Bit late for that. Yeah, I mean, if he'd have done it earlier, actually, it would have been really worth it.
It would have been full 20 stacks, yeah, easy.
It would have been worth it by now. Actually, you can see just taking down that blue buff. Obviously, as Steven said, Baron is not so far away, and well, we can see that Coralol is doing his preparation work over by Baron, and that is a lot of vision.
That's a lot of wards.
That's a lot of wards, but they can afford it, let's be honest with you. Janna's currently 8.5k gold on her for the whole game, which is almost as much as the highest earner on the other team. Which tells you a big story. Obviously, Twisted Fate passive, even though it's not all that amazing, to be fair, you get an extra couple of gold every time, so that's not bad. That's added to things as well. And it looks like we could see him going in here. Blunatix, he's a little bit alone, but logiX are basically scared of him, and that's the major point about this situation, that they are scared of every single one, possibly not Coralol. But still, they'll not want to try and take it down anyway, because they'll feel that the rest of the team stood somewhere behind. And, well, that Baron has spawned. And look at this. Are we going to see a repeat? Oh, there's the Miss Cleaver. Oh, there's a ward in there this time. And they are going to go in there. Sleazy Weezy has gone in. And, well, it pretty much is a repeat. Not quite. Coralol goes down. But to be quite honest with you, I'm not sure that they're going to be too bothered when they've lost their support. Here comes the port in from Twisted Fate, and Blood Dragon's going to be finished off here very, very quickly. Carry On has actually flashed the wrong way. That was, I think, a prediction flash as he went to try and switch that one out. In the meantime, we've got Tabuno chasing in for Kennen. And he actually pretty much just missed everything. There's the Valkyrie, though, and Kennen is going to go down to Corki, and that means this middle turret is down. It means the inhibitor is down. And will they stop there? They're surely going to go bottom and then the top lane. Mundo is still trying to hold on, but you can see they're actually pushing through in towards these Nexus turrets. And if they can get at least one of these Nexus turrets down, they'll be very, very happy with themselves. That Nexus turret does go down. Are they going to fancy themselves a second one as well? Attack Man here being pressured by Mundo, but he certainly doesn't have the damage to compete with them whatsoever. And there's a wild card to finish off from Attack Man. Second Nexus turret is not quite going to go down. That would have been worth sticking around just for that one, to be quite honest with you, because that will start to regen itself. Corki did take down the top turret as well. So just across the board. And I'd be interested to see how Riot's new spectator mode with its smart camera follow would have handled the action in the last 5 minutes of this game.
I've got to be honest, when I saw it, I was thinking, you know, I've seen a few games, I'm not sure how well that's going to work. So it was really going to put it to the test, the scripters, the coders, how well they've done about this smart camera function. There's a lot of things on it that they're obviously going to take a bit of getting used to, certainly for us commentators as well. But 26-9 is the score, and that, well, as you can see, it's a 22k gold difference, which, wow, is just huge. And to put that in perspective, you can add the entire bottom lane, that is Kog'Maw and Nunu together, and you'll get what Attackman's got, which is a lot of gold right now. And he's actually picked up a Quicksilver Sash now, so he's switched out to the final Doran's Ring I think he had on there. Bear in mind, he went triple Doran's Ring as well. So, you know, he's gone through the motions. He's not just gone straight for those items. He's gone through the motions to build it up and come out with that fantastic amount of gold that he's got. We can see a glistening Tabuna. They didn't pick up Baron, remember, so now they've gone back for it. And honestly, I don't think there's anything logiX can do about it, so it will be a completely frag Baron. Attackman uses ulti just to double check and say, yes, they are all in the base. We will take this one away. And we're just going to stomp our way through. They got an open inhibitor at the top there. Bottom inhibitor was stripped out. Middle inhibitor was stripped out. Bottom Nexus turret is on absolutely nothing. I think this could well be signifying the end unless something absolutely devastating along the lines of someone having a complete seizure. I don't know. I really don't know if there's any other way other than actual death in the event that could cause a problem for Peculiar here.
Yeah, and we can see pushing through. Top inhibitor just absolutely mashed through. There's not a thing they can do to stop that happening. Obviously, Kog'Maw using his range just to try and keep him at bay, but Attackman walks straight in there. One card doing like half a turret damage almost, and there is the Nexus, and that will be Peculiar Gaming winning game number one here in the second semi-final of the EPS Germany Grand Finals, or the BenQ Finals, and a thoroughly well-deserved one as well. We said they were underdogs. They were up against the big, big favorites to win this entire tournament after going 9-0 in the group. They won their quarterfinal a couple of weekends ago.